let's talk about uploading podcasts from an RSS feed to YouTube. If you're an audio-first podcast creator, you can submit your podcast RSS feed to YouTube, which will upload your podcast episodes to YouTube and YouTube Music. Let's walk through what RSS feeds are, how they work with YouTube, and how to submit them in YouTube Studio. First, why do podcasters use RSS feeds? Many podcasters use an RSS feed to distribute their podcasts across different platforms. Setting up an RSS feed is something that can be done outside of YouTube using third-party platforms. When you upload a podcast episode to your RSS feed, it will automatically be made available on all the podcast platforms your feed is connected to. This means you only need to upload an episode once, and it will be distributed to multiple places. Next, how do RSS feeds work with YouTube? When you submit your RSS feed to YouTube, a static image video will be created for podcast episodes on your RSS feed. YouTube will use your podcast episode or show art to create the static image video. When a new episode is added to your RSS feed, YouTube will automatically upload the static image video to your channel on your behalf and notify your eligible subscribers. Your podcast and its episodes will then be available on YouTube and YouTube Music. There's no subscriber requirement to use the RSS upload tool, but you'll need to have access to advanced features. You can check if you have access to advanced features by going to YouTube Studio, then Settings, then Channel, then Feature Eligibility. Now, let's walk through how to submit a podcast RSS feed to YouTube. First, head to YouTube Studio and hit Create, then New Podcast. Choose Submit RSS Feed. Next, you'll need to review the terms of service. If you agree to the terms, click Accept. At the next step, you'll need to enter your RSS feed URL, then click Next. Here, you'll need to verify ownership of the RSS feed by entering the code sent to the email address you use on your RSS feed. Enter the code, then click Verify. This will lead you to the upload step. Here, you can choose to upload old episodes from your RSS feed. You can choose to upload all episodes in your feed, choose to upload episodes published since a certain date, or choose to not upload any old episodes. Note that if you choose to upload old episodes from the RSS feed during the setup phase, they'll be uploaded as private initially, and your channel subscribers won't receive notifications for them. They will only receive notifications once your podcast is published on YouTube and new episodes are uploaded from your RSS feed. At the upload step, you'll also have the option to set a default paid promotion setting for your episodes. To comply with YouTube's terms of service, podcast content that you upload to YouTube cannot contain advertisements, but your podcast can include paid promotions like host-read promotions, sponsorships, or endorsements. You're just required to let us know. You can click the checkbox to set it as a default for any episode uploaded from your RSS feed. You can also change this later at the podcast or video level in Studio. Note that we'll let viewers know that the video contains a paid promotion when this setting is checked. Once you've made your selections, click Next. Finally, you'll reach the visibility step. At this point, you can click Save to finish your RSS feed setup. Remember, your past episodes will be uploaded as private videos, and you'll still need to publish your podcast, so nothing will be made public by clicking Save and finishing setup. You can click View Podcasts to go to the Podcast tab. From here, you'll need to publish your podcast. Note that once you've created your podcast from the RSS feed, it can take some time to upload the selected episodes. You'll see how many episodes are left to upload. We recommend waiting until all the episodes are uploaded and copyright checks are finished before publishing. Once you've confirmed there aren't any copyright issues for the episodes that were uploaded, you can click the Publish button next to your podcast. Remember, your subscribers won't receive any notifications at this point, only when you upload new episodes moving forward. Now let's walk through editing your podcast once it's published. If you want to edit your podcast show details, hover over it in the Podcast tab and click the pencil icon. You can edit things like title, description, and thumbnail. You can also disconnect the RSS feed and change the default visibility of new uploads from the feed. For individual episodes, keep in mind that YouTube will sync changes you make from the RSS feed to YouTube, including an episode's title, description, and release date. If you want to edit the details of an individual episode to be YouTube specific, you can still edit any of these fields directly, just like any other video. To do this, click into your episode and you can make edits from the details page. You can always choose to revert back to the RSS value if you change your mind. To do this, click the three-dot menu, then View Sync Status. Under Status, click Revert to RSS. If you already have podcasts on YouTube, you can also connect your existing podcast to an RSS feed. Under Podcasts on the Content tab, find the podcast you want to edit and click the pencil icon, which will lead you to the details page. Under RSS settings, click Connect to RSS feed and follow the prompts. To avoid uploading duplicate episodes, we recommend setting the upload date to after the last published episode in your RSS feed. Finally, let's walk through some things to keep in mind when it comes to using an RSS feed to upload your podcast to YouTube. Note that YouTube won't distribute your podcast to other platforms. Although YouTube will automatically sync changes made to your episode details, we won't automatically update show detail changes made from your RSS feed. If you want to edit these details on YouTube, you can do so on the podcast details page. YouTube will also not automatically update audio files that are re-uploaded to your RSS feed. If you want to update the audio for an episode, from the video details page, click the three-dot menu, then re-upload from RSS feed. For more information on submitting a podcast RSS feed to YouTube, check out the links in the description. Thanks for watching!